Tonight, it'll be the Phoenix Mercury going up against the Seattle Storm. Along with Tim Swartz and Brian Benefitemi, I'm Blake Suniga, and we're happy to have you along for another great game. Well, guys, we're right in the thick of things now as the WNBA Finals roll on.
Yeah, this has been a lot of fun, guys. And honestly, sitting next to you two has made this a lot more fun. But oftentimes, when you look at a series like this, it can shift based on momentum. Let's see if that's the case tonight.
So it's important to get going early in this one. And you also can't afford to play sloppy. Take care of the rock and get quality, not the first look, but quality looks at the basket.
Now here's Diggins Smith. Pass to Breland. Three, Diana Taurasi. It's good from long range.
With a beautiful outside stroke, Taurasi strikes fear in the eyes of her opponents.
Now Bird. To the left wing. Here's Stewart. Steps back and drains the J.
It still went down, but with no defender near her, no need to go the fadeaway route.
Diggins Smith with it. Picked up by Stewart. A nice shot by Diggins Smith.
That's a true point guard going to work right there. I mean, Diggins Smith frequently gives her team the best opportunity to score.
Now here is Lloyd. A drive by Natasha Howard. And it's blocked by Brittany Griner. Pass to Diggins Smith. Coffey. Now Diggins Smith. Clock at six. Out to Taurasi. The floater. Second shot opportunity. And there's a nice layup by Griner.
What an instinctual nose for the ball. Griner just cleans up the glass so efficiently.
Outside Stewart. And it's out of bounds to the Storm as Seattle retains possession. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played. Shot clock at six. Outside Lloyd. Off the mark there with the three.
They got lucky. They got lucky. And the defense has taken a big chance leaving her open behind the arc. I'm not sure I'm okay with that game plan.
Now here is Stewart. And Sue Bird, here we go. Bucket is good.
She's done it so many times over her career, but it's still impressive. At 5'9", Bird finishing at the hoop.
Pass to Taurasi. No good from three-point territory.
Yeah, her touch has deserted her this quarter. Nowhere to be found.
Outside Stewart.
Call on the screen!
And fouled hard that time, and she'll get two shots at the line.
Solid amount of contact on that play, but Stewart's a tough-minded player who can do just about anything down low.
This is her first trip to the free throw line tonight.
Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw missing.
When you think of Brianna Stewart, you think winner. She won four college championships, has an Olympic gold medal, and a WNBA title.
Ties it up. Big free throw right there. First quarter of play and just over 3.5 minutes in. Pass to Coffey. Griner inside. It's good, and she drew the contact on the shot, so she'll go to the line. 3-point play opportunity. Lloyd. He's covered closely. That one falls. her second basket of the game. She is now 2 for 3. Pass to Coffey. Breland with the ball. Here's Coffey. Now here is Breland. Over Lloyd. Howard with the rebound.
The defense can't make a habit of giving her that shot. She just doesn't miss many of them.
Bird outside. Back to Stewart. Howard. Bird outside. And she's good on the three ball.
Shooting off the pass, it really allows you to square up, feel comfortable. Bird looked really comfortable there.
To Taurasi. Back to Diggins Smith. Floats one up. Good work defensively by Natasha Howard. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have. Staying aggressive and playing in control. The easy look off the pass from Howard. Great awareness leads to the bucket.
Now here's Diggins Smith. Coffey outside, Diggins Smith. Can they get it? It's rebounded by Seattle. Outside Stewart. On the wing, Jewel Lloyd. Diana Taurasi with some really nice knee. And they've been struggling here offensively.
Bit of a dry spell for sure.
Yep, that goes.
Effective around the rim. Taurasi is well-rounded. She can finish with a multitude of moves.
Time called here. The Storm decide to talk it over.
Well, they want to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and now's the time to do it.
Yeah, there was clearly some things going on out there that the coaching staff just wasn't a fan of.
Pass to Canada. Outside Whitcomb. Over to the wing. Six to shoot. And here's Canada. From outside the arc. And again, it's the Storm missing. Down low. Turner. One up, one down. 2 points with her first shot in this game.
Backed by her solid footwork, Turner knows a thing or two about scoring inside.
Here's Canada. Rhea Hartley with some nice D.
If they could end every possession with that shot, they'd be happy, because 9 times out of 10, that's an easy layup.
And unable there to get the go-ahead bucket.
Well, good defense in the paint. Worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and we just saw it right there, didn't we? Without her presence, that's an easy 2 points.
Here's Walker Kimbrough. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Clark outside. To the inside. And 2 free throws coming up as she misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. It's going to go on Brittany Griner.
Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First one falls forward. Both teams deciding to change it up. Both shots good from the stripe. The Mercury trail. And there's the foul. It'll go on Clark. That is her first foul of the game. And it's the Mercury with the ball. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Now Griner. Here's Hartley. Clock at 4. And she gets the bucket.
In the paint. Griner simply unstoppable. She's so tall at 6'9", but she also has lovely touch.
Now here's Whitcomb. Rhea Hartley with some nice D. Floats one. Turner. No good that time. So the Storm will take it the other way. Fast break. Here we go. Here's Russell. Griner with the rebound. They could retake the lead after trailing for a while.
And such nice work to hang around and put themselves in this position.
Now here's Hartley. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Shoots over Whitcomb. Walker Kimbrough misses. Up top, Whitcomb. G's guarded by Hartley. Clark outside. Langhorne. Clark. G's guarded by Griner. Here's Canada. And the Storm miss again. Out to the left wing. Pass to Turner. Hartley outside. To the paint. Griner's shot is good.
She was one step ahead of the D in making that pass. Nice assist.
One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one. Mercury out in front. They lead by 2. And we'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. Think about the Mercury here in this one.
The work they've done to get in close offensively, the difference right now.
And I like that they aren't settling for outside shots. Just keep attacking the rim.
Very aggressive.
And here's Canada. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Tipped away, stolen by Yvonne Turner. Lays it in off the breakaway. The Storm trail. Outside Whitcomb. Knocked loose. It's stolen by Griner. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Good. And the assist goes to Bria Hartley.
Nice pass there to set up the bucket.
And 10 of their last 12 points have come off assists.
Pass to Whitcomb. Six on the shot clock. Russell. He's guarded by Griner. Langhorne. Banked in off the glass.
That rebound and the follow, it shows you what she's all about. Gritty, determined, and a soft touch to match.
Now here's Hartley. Back to Griner. Another shot. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the line.
You know, they've been extremely efficient and effective getting the ball inside.
Totally. I mean, we're seeing some real shortcomings from this defense. They've given up 5 straight good looks in the paint.
Second quarter now, and they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
Knocks it loose. Pass to Howard. Foul called that time on the way up, and that'll give her 2 chances at the free throw. It's going to go on Brittany Griner.
Natasha Howard. 2 shots.
shooting two.
And she knocks down the first one.
A bench player over her first 4 years in the league, Natasha Howard finally got the chance to start in 2018 with Seattle, helping the Storm to a WNBA championship.
She hits both from the stripe. Phoenix leading. Breland outside. Hartley. Pass to Griner. Launches it. Offensive rebound. It's good on the putback.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is if they keep allowing easy looks inside.
So the whistle blows on the shot. Two free throws for the contact there.
Well, probably the right play defensively. If you can't get the block, send them to the line.
Exactly. You want to prevent the layup, give them a little knock, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming down the lane the next time around.
It does send a message.
And she makes the first.
They're having some success from the free throw line, and they better keep it up if they want to win.
The Storm making a switch here. So she hits both of them.
This is the way to stay in the game. They're doing a masterful job from the line. 100% in the quarter.
Pass to Turner. Jordan Canada with the steal. Clark with it. Here's Langhorne. That one's off. She's now 1 for 2. Here's Hartley. To the middle. Jordan Canada with the steal. Side Howard. Over Breland. Howard, that's good.
Well, she can really get up on her jumpers. It helps Howard be good deep, just shooting over players.
Poked away. Pass to Canada. Now here is Lloyd. Now here is Howard. She's guarded by Hartley. Shot clock at 6. The 3. Here's Clark. It doesn't go for her. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. Here's Turner, guarded by Canada. Now Griner. Hartley outside. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. It's going to go on Alicia Clark. Good on both. Seattle trailing here. Now Bird. She's got 5. On the wing, Jewel Lloyd. She's guarded by Hartley. Clock at 6. Lloyd. It's in. That's her 3rd field goal of the game. She's 3 for 5.
Never easy to score like that, but Lloyd is a player who scores in tough situations. She has tremendous finishing ability.
Now here's Hartley. And it's blocked by Brianna Stewart. And they'll keep possession.
Well, it wasn't a block officially, but it might as well been. She really affected that shot.
Yeah, it was clearly her defense that threw her off there.
Unfazed by that scoreless first quarter, and she's heating up.
Here's Niggan Smith. Pass to Hartley. Megan Smith, and here's Breland, guarded by Howard. Back back to Diggins Smith. Shoots the three, brings it from beyond the arc.
A part of Diggins Smith's game that she continues to work on, but a fiery competitor like her never sets limits on what they can and can't do.
Now here is Stewart. 5 points in the game. And the foul called on Griner. That is her third foul so far. Outside Lloyd. Six to shoot. It's rebounded by Phoenix.
Great defense right there to prevent one of the best finishers in the league from converting in close.
Over to the left wing. Here's Coffey, guarded by Howard. Coffey, no good.
And terrific defense at the rim, got right in her path.
And you know they'll be worrying about her next time they take it inside, too. And really, that's what great defenders will do to you.
Bird, guarded by Diggins Smith. From downtown, Griner with the rebound. Phoenix leading. Outside, Diggins Smith. Coffey. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Pass to Coffey. And again, Phoenix with the triple.
What a passer. Diana Taurasi sees the game like few ever have. Finds teammates in great positions.
Outside Howard. Here's Bird. Langhorn left side. It's stolen by Griner. Pass to Coffey. Griner with the ball. Here's Taurasi. And there's another one for the Mercury.
You just love to see that poise. And Taurasi always seems to have the game under control. She's a true vet.
Now here's Bird. He has 5. Outside Stewart. Brianna Stewart draws the double. Langhorn, he's guarded by Griner.
Well, standing perimeter defense there. That one well contested.
Yeah, she's kind of like the anti-Tim, right? I mean, she puts a lot of dedication into her defense, and there are no easy threes if she's on you.
Now here's Howard. 6 points for her. Lloyd up top. No good. Unable to end this run. Coffey, guarded by Howard. Pass to Diggins Smith. Now Griner, covered by Langhorn. They double team Brittany Griner. And Superb picks up the foul. That's her first foul. So both teams changing it up here. Outside Diggins Smith. Stolen away. Job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt right there. Bird outside from 12 feet out. Mercury with the rebound. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. Howard gets the bucket.
Well, you like to give maybe a degree of difficulty bonus there for Howard. Great concentration to put it through the hoop.
To the left side wing. Brianna Stewart with the steal. And it's the Storm on the break. And she lays it up and in.
Look at Stewart go. Look, she's versatile and not afraid to push the tempo to score some fast break points.
About 3 seconds between the shot clock and game clock. Outside Diggins Smith. Taurasi. Clock at 6. Full reverse layup.
Oh, she's got such a great touch and feel around the rim. She made that reverse look easy, but trust me when I tell you, it's not.
And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that has been very close so far. It's the Mercury. They lead by 4. We'll be right back to the action when we return.
seeing a tremendous game from Brittany Griner.
Quite simply, she's been terrific. This is just what they need from her.
And a double-double in just one half of basketball? You can't ask for anything more as a coach, teammate, or fan.
Well, both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break, and we'll see if one can pull away in the third.
Now here's Howard. And she lays it straight in.
There's a pattern taking shape. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Yeah, four of their last five baskets have been of exactly that variety.
Here's Diggins-Smith. Rossi outside. Pass to Griner. Tarasi, covered by Lloyd. And the basket by Tarasi.
Ooh, an unselfish play from an unselfish player. Griner is a respected locker room figure.
Now here's Howard. Bird outside. Shoots over Diggins-Smith. There's the foul. It's on Howard. That's foul number two for her. And with a little over a minute gone by, the second half underway. Outside, Diggins-Smith. Pass to Griner. Couldn't get it to drop. She's now made 5 of 8 shots. Bird outside. Back to Howard. That one a little long.
That's a shot she had to take.
No question. The decision was good. Just didn't execute.
Here's Coffey. Sweet little floater.
Oh, that's an elegant move to drop in the floater.
Seattle trailing here. Pass to Lloyd. Freeland grabs the miss.
Tough D on the inside.
Sure was. No easy access to the bucket when she's in the middle.
Here's Coffey. Defended by Stewart. Coffey, no good. Outside Howard. To the wing on the left. Bird outside. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And they double up Natasha Howard. Their offense stone cold. Another miss there.
They start the second half 1 for 4.
Here's Coffey. And she was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws for her. It's on Sue Bird.
Shooting 2.
And the first one drops, and the Mercury making a change here. He's off on the second. Pass to Canada. And she takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
Great job to find the open teammate. Stewie has very solid vision.
Griner with the ball. And it's Bria Hartley penetrating. Canada grabs the board. And here are the Storm now. Since halftime, they've only allowed 5 points. And the basket by Lewis.
Scoring inside, they're able to do it despite being under 6 feet.
To Hartley, launches it, knocks down the 3-ball.
No matter who it is, that kind of D isn't going to cut it.
Stewart with the ball. She's guarded by Hartley. And here is Lloyd. Takes the 3. The Storm rebound. Stewart, the putback, controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
There you go. Relentless pursuit of the ball. I love it. He never stopped working.
Pass to Griner. Hartley. From 17 feet out. And again, it's Phoenix.
They can't afford to give her that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you have to fight over the top of it.
And you need some help as well.
Now here is Stewart. She has 7. Brittany Griner with a defensive effort.
Just a slight advantage for them in the rebound department.
Yeah, especially when you're scoring the ball at even a decent clip. They've done what's necessary to take the lead.
Here's Hartley. He's got 7. Timeout called from Mercury.
Coach saw that the players were getting a little run down out there. The timeout should give them a little energy back.
To the wing. Griner guarded by Russell. Shot clock at 6. A nice shot by Griner.
Her efficient scoring. A nice lift to their offense tonight.
Outside Canada. The shot will not fall. And the Mercury going the other way now.
The shot's just not dropping for her today.
He gets it in there.
She has some impressive moves in her collection. That's a good one, but really, it's one of many.
Down low. Pass to Russell. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
They're just killing them in the paint.
You can say that again. I mean, the defenders aren't being nearly aggressive enough down low.
They're just killing them in the paint.
Thank you.
Now here's Hartley. She's got 7. Good work defensively by Sammy Whitcomb.
Her shot has been off today. With her team leading, perhaps she should maybe focus more on her floor game.
Turner, guarded by Canada. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Here's Turner. She's covered by Clark. Turner with the bucket. Seattle trailing here. Clark outside. Stewart. Griner with the rebound.
Excellent interior D right there to force the miss.
Yeah, and unlike you, Tim, her defensive ability is a huge factor. No doubt about it.
Now here is Canada. She's got 6. So she earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact and she'll shoot 2.
Fouled on that play, but Stewart isn't worried. She's tough and relishes any chance she can get to score some points.
And she'll take her 3rd and 4th free throw shots of the night. And the first one at the line is good. She gets them both. Phoenix leading. Here's Turner. Rossi outside. Pass to Griner. Here's Turner from deep. Russell pulls it in.
He had all the time in the world to get that shot off.
Canada with the bucket. Mercury with possession. Rossi outside. To the paint. That's good. And so Brittany Griner gets the assist.
Some defensive breakdowns happening now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
And giving up these high percentage shot attempts, it's not going to get it done. They need to figure it out.
Time called here. The Storm decide to talk it over. It's been quite a game for Diana Taurasi.
She's been attacking the rim with force. They need to deny her the ball in the paint. Keep her away from the bucket. Stewart. Six on the shot clock. From downtown. That shot missing. Now Phoenix takes it the other way.
She has been anything but her usual self this quarter. It's been ugly.
And it's good for two.
They own the paint right now. 10 straight coming from the inside.
They are constantly finding lanes to the hoop, getting great looks in tight.
Stolen by Diggin Smith. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Taurasi outside. Shot clock at 5. From past the arc. Howard with the rebound.
They should use a little clock here.
Yeah, melt the clock with this possession.
Stewart with the ball. He's got 9. This one for 3. No good on the last second attempt there. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Mercury out in front, leading by 10. And we'll have the start of the fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. Just bust when I get me some. Go on here, get you some. Yeah, get you some. Can't wait till I get me some. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
Well, I'm so happy we get to see this pass just one more time. A magnificent feed. You love to see the two kind of taking over the playmaking duties with this much skill.
Yeah, that is some dime dropping, guys. Accurate and on time.
The fourth quarter just moments away now as we welcome you back. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Pass to Griner. She can't get that one. Excellent D there from Mercedes Russell. To the inside. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two. That one on Diggin Smith. The first one falls. So she hits 1 of 2 from the stripe. Walker Kimbrough, defended by Stewart. Pass to Diggin Smith. Griner. And she drops in the layup off glass.
Those defenders look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're just getting pushed around on the low block. Maybe coach has got to make a substitution or something to energize his team.
Well, they better rally soon. They've given up three straight buckets in the paint.
Now here is Stewart.
The putback. Great positioning on the putback.
And that's some gritty work on the offensive glass. Coach has got to be happy.
Pass to Griner. Reeland, guarded by Russell.
It's stolen by Natasha Howard.
Over to the left wing.
Here's Stewart. And it's blocked by Brittany Griner.
Such a strong defensive prowess. I love how Griner makes shooters dig not once, not twice, probably at least three times before shooting the rock around her.
Will Mercury making a switch here?
Clock at two.
Bird,
18 feet away, and she knocks it down.
It's the forgotten part of the floor, the in-between area. But Bird still knocks them down from here, catches opponents off guard.
Outside, Diggins Smith. Pass to Gerasi. 18 feet out, and right through it goes.
A competitive player with high-level intangibles. Rossi's been torching defenses for years.
Now here is Stewart. Bird outside. Russell.
Brittany Griner with a defensive effort.
That's the way you want to defend. Nice job there.
Always so important to have that strong interior defense.
Stolen by Jessica Breland.
Pass to Diggins Smith. Now here's Griner. And here is Diggins Smith. Inside.
Griner, good.
Sometimes you look at Brittany Griner and you think she is an unstoppable force. A little bump, it doesn't do anything to stop her. She's so locked in on scoring.
Now here is Stewart.
And the bucket counts, and she's on her way to the line.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. Here in the fourth quarter, just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Pass to Coffey.
Griner with the ball.
He can't hit that time. Some solid defense from Brianna Stewart.
Well, they're winning despite her errant shooting.
And there's the foul. It'll go on Bria Hartley. That is her first foul of the game. Bird. She's guarded by Hartley. Bird outside. Shoots from the line.
I really think she's the most impactful defender in league history. Griner, a two-time defensive player of the year.
To the inside. Good for her eighth field goal. She's attempted a dozen shots.
They've been able to depend on her offense all game, guys. She's just not wasting any chances, any shots she's had.
And if they want to make things even easier on themselves here late in the ball game, I got an idea. Just keep getting her the basketball. Her ability is matched only by her energy, guys. She's usually in the middle of everything for that.
Down low. So she gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots. Next.
An elite athlete for a player of her build. Griner's willing to battle on the interior.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Throw is good.
The top pick in the 2013 draft, Brittany Griner, had insane expectations coming into this league. And guess what? She's delivered, winning a WNBA title in 2014 and a scoring title in 2017.
so she hits both. Here's Lloyd. Bird outside. Here's Russell. And so she draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line, but she too. It's going to go on Brittany Griner. That one's off. And she misses the second one as well. So 0 for 2 that time. Hartley outside. Pass to Taurasi. Coffee. Shot clock at 6. Griner, no good.
Well, you love the tough D, especially inside.
And that's exactly what she gives you, Tim. Constantly making her presence felt around the rim.
Now here is Stewart. And it's blocked by Brittany Griner. To the middle. Taurasi, the basket drops, and she gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming up for her.
She's a once-in-a-generation player. Taurasi is not only the all-time leading scorer in WNBA history, she's also top 5 in assists. Offensively, defensively, everything. She's done it all.
Seattle calls timeout.
Really, they're not pleased at all with the looks they've given up inside, and they want to talk to the team about tightening things up defensively.
Well, that's what's got to happen, and I'm sure the coaches will let them know about it. I mean, they're playing some soft interior defense, and that's a recipe for disaster.
And yet again, a game where she's been a monster on the glass. A bunch of rebounds for her, and that's not by accident. It's all from constant effort and aggressive pursuit of the ball on every possession.
The WNBA Finals is where great players tend to shine. This game will forever go down as one of her best performances ever.
Here's Bird. To Stewart. Jacks up a 3. And the Storm miss again. And a fast break now for the Mercury. Took him no time at all on that one.
Well, the first thought from the D there was to protect the rim. So good idea to take the transition 3.
They need to stop this run.
I think it's time to switch things up, either by going to the bench or with a different look defensively.
On the wing, Jewel Lloyd. Guarded by Hartley. Back to Stewart. The basket good off the assist from Sue Bird.
Dropping dime. Bird has incredible vision and feel. She sees the whole court.
And the Mercury call time here.
They could tell their players are dragging a bit and called timeout to let them catch their breath.
Here the Mercury. Pass to Breland. Wide open. And the Mercury tack on two more.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Great ball movement.
Great ball movement indeed. That's an example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Now Russell. Drive to shoot. Over Griner.
A good board there, but overall, they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
And they've just got to find a way to get back into this game. That's as good a place as any.
Just increase the effort on the board.
Now here's Bird. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus.
Pass to Russell. From 11 feet away. Here's Stewart. So the whistle blows on the shot. Two free throws for the contact there. The first one falls. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. Now here's Hartley. Pass to Griner. To the paint. Here's Breland. That's good. And so Brittany Griner gets the assist.
A tall, physical presence. Breland does the majority of her damage from the interior.
Outside Stewart. Right side Howard. Pass to Bird. Clock is at three. Lloyd with the three. No good there. And it's Phoenix the other way. Here is Hartley. Up top to Rossi. Here's Griner. Oh, draws the hard foul and she'll head to the line.
Physicality and drawing fouls are just two of Griner's many strengths. So a little contact won't really bother her.
Griner at the line for two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one drops, so both teams making some changes here. That's also good, so she hits them both. Here's Prince. Pass to Tuck. Prince. She's guarded by Griner. Count that bucket.
Very clever passing. She put that ball on a silver platter for her.
Here's Cunningham. Here's Smith. Whitcomb defending. Down low. Griner shot's good.
I don't want to say that they're trying to run up the score, but and you keep adding up to that lead.
Well, if you won't say it, partner, I will. They're trying to run up the score here.
Thanks for saying that, Brian.
Here's Tuck. Pass to Prince. But they'll get another chance. Outside Whitcomb. To the wing, right side. Prince. Good on the triple.
She had her head on a swivel. And was able to still pick up the pass and get the assist.
And they can just sit on the ball here.
Enjoy it. They've earned the win.
No doubt. Pass to Breland. From the stripe. Storm with the rebound. And so it's Phoenix easily grabbing this one.